In our last video, we talked about the order topology, and we proved that the order topology, let's call it like this, in the real line, was the same topology as the standard one in the real line. Then we also talked about what was the order topology in R2. We were able to describe the open intervals in the order dictionary, and we know that those open intervals were the ones that generated this topology. But we didn't talk about what was the standard topology in the plane, so we don't know if these two things are equal or not. So what is the standard topology in the plane? You're probably thinking about, well, it's going to be the product of open intervals. Because if single intervals are the standard topology in the real line, then it makes sense that the product is just the product of the intervals. And it is true, but the matter is a bit more complicated than just that. What we're going to do is, we're going to talk about the product topology, not in the real numbers, but in a more general setting. So we will suppose we have two sets with one topology each, and we want to take the product of those two sets and define a topology in the product space. We have X and Y, two topological spaces. Remember that what this meant is we have the set X with its own topology tau X, and the set Y with its own topology tau Y. And we want to define the product topology on the space X times Y. The product topology is going to be defined via its basis. So it's going to be the topology generated by these bases. And the basis is quite simple. It's just the product of open sets in X and Y. So UB are open sets in X and Y means that this is going to be the product U times B of elements U in the X topology and V in the Y topology. We grab two sets, each with its own topology, and we take the product of the elements in each topology. Well, that set is going to give us the basis. So then we just take arbitrary unions and finite intersections, and we have the product topology in the product space. Well, if you look at this, it might seem like it's a bit more complicated than just taking product of open intervals, because we're actually taking U and B elements in the topology. So in the real line, U and B could be way more complicated than just an open interval. However, there is one famous result that says that if we have X with its topology, that this topology is being generated by some basis Bx, and the same for Y. So we have Y with its own topology that's being generated by a basis By. Then the basis for the product topology, so this basis B, it's actually the product of U times B for the elements of the basis, U in Bx and B in By. So the first definition we gave was a bit more general because we didn't require our spaces to have a basis. But in the cases where our spaces do have a basis, then we can just simplify things a bit and define the new basis this way. Obviously, these two bases are the same. So in the cases where X and Y do have bases, Bx and By, it doesn't really matter which of these two definitions we take for the product topology. So now we do have what I mentioned at the beginning of the video, that the topology in the plane is going to be the one generated by, let's call it P2, the basis of AB times CD, where AB, C and D are all real numbers. It is going to be the product of open intervals, meaning that this is just the basis, and then the topology would be any countable union or finite intersection of these elements. So this topology is going to be called the standard topology in R2, or the product topology in R2. And it's easy to realize that this topology is very different to that of the dictionary order topology. Because if you think about the open sets, in our dictionary order, we said that we had here one extreme of the interval and another one. And so the topology was going to be a set like this with everything in the middle. These were our intervals, and so our topology was going to be unions and intersections of these types of elements. So this is the real numbers, the plane with the order topology. But now, in the product topology, it's just going to be the product of open intervals. So if I have an open interval here and another one here, my open sets are now going to be unions of these types of objects. So they are squares without the borders because these are all open intervals. And now all this is very different from these type of things. A possible question now is, okay, the order dictionary topology in any product space is not necessarily the same as the product topology. So can those two be the same? And also, what happens when we have a subspace of our space? So here I'm working with a plane, but what would happen if instead of working with the whole plane, I wanted just to focus on some set A like this, and the same here. If I want to focus on a set A, what will be now my open sets? And what topology will I choose for my set A? We will see in the following videos that there are many ways to define topologies in subspaces. So stay tuned if you want to learn more about that. If you want to support the channel, we have many ways of doing so. The simplest one is via a small donation on Ko-fi. Every little donation is helping our channel grow. We also have a t-shirt store where you can buy amazing mathematics t-shirts, and also Patreon, where our subscribers get great merchandise, access to the boards, and many other perks. Check out all those things with the links in the description of the video.